They even had some Polynesian navigators, but the last one I knew about died before we could ask him. There was nobody left, but I did find a Micronesian.
We knew that Mao was a professional, a really good navigator, and he was at the end of a tradition that had been unbroken. And so our tradition had been broken, and we thought it would be a good idea to bring Mao in to patch it up again.
He wanted to find out about our project, because he said, in my country, my children are not learning how to navigate. They're going to forget everything, we're going to lose everything, and we'll quit making canoes. So I told him that was the situation in Hawaii already. And he also saw that we didn't know how to sail very well. So he says, I'm going to stay and keep helping you. So he did.
This blessing be upon you as you go as a Viking from Hawaii. I bless you, Dr. Feeney, as a scientist from Hawaii. I bless you, Mao, who have come so far away to help us.
Mao said, you know, when you go to sea in Honolulu, you're, you know, the navigator, he says, you got to leave all your land trouble on land. Because you need them to be together. And he said, if we fail, we all fail together.
God bless you and be with you, Hoku, so that you may be part of this expedition. Bye-bye, John.
I don't think I was scared. I think I was, you know, here, you're out here to learn. You got this guy that's can see all the magic, you know. As long as you knew that if you looked at Mao and he wasn't, you know, he might have been apprehensive because he thought, who are these guys that got on this canoe? And then, and you know, he probably had some his own fears about us.
Aloha.
And we got right into the teeth of it, right? You know, we went around that backside, so we're in this stuff right from the very beginning. And it's wet, and we're on the deck. I mean, it's just miserable.
We did not succeed in having a united crew. We had people working at cross purposes.
You could say management and crew. You could say science versus culture.
And Mao as a you know, that he's supposed to be the navigator. The guy that shows you the magic, right? He was torn between the two, you know.
Boogie was he was the one that lightened things up. You know, they pulled out the guitar and everything got nice, you know. And the canoe would start to dance too, you know.
The song that they made is "Stand Beside Me and Be My Friend," because I'm always arguing with him. You better not sleep, just keep on playing. And he would play and play and pass out. And then when he gets up, he's ready to the same tone, you know.
We're 3 days out, here comes his seaplane, Coast Guard, they drop the packet. We sail up to it, pick it up. Everybody got to get the shot.
The possibility we had contracted hepatitis because one of the food preparers had hepatitis that prepared the food for us in Honolulu.
He's like this, he's shaking like crazy. Canoe's rocking and rolling. Boogie grabs it and give me that thing. I'll do my own shot. And then Tommy Holmes, he's deathly afraid of needles, right? Buffalo and Doogie holding him down.
Boogie wrote a song, Hepatitis Blues.
We took apart the holly halfway down there because all the thatch came from when we were at Honolulu, all the pineapple bugs came on that thing.
So if you're sitting in your hall, underneath that thing, army worms would start dropping from the... Okay, look at this!
Oh, maggots, right? Get big guy. Wow, what's that? Oh, it's all the eggs. I mean, you know, we're going to throw it away. First thing I'm going to do, I'm going to give my share to Maxwell. Maxwell, he'll eat anything. Mao's going, no. He gets a coconut, gets all those maggot things and put them in the fire, eat them. Say, eat it, say, protein. I was looking at him, I was like, nah, go eat the fish, brah.
He scolded us after that when you go swimming, he says, you know, you swim, that you tend to get thirsty. So you start drinking water, limited supply of water.
I'm just like trying to learn everything all at once. So whatever he did, whatever he's looking at, if he's looked there, then I look there and ask him what he's looking at.
And Charlie, he's always with Mao because he's there to learn navigation with Mao and also to keep other people away so don't interrupt him while he's praying. And he's praying every day, every night.
He did what he was trained and how he did it in the past. And that's for me. That was he calls all that stuff magic. And so I got to watch him do his magic.
He had to find a place he'd never been to before, work with a sky he'd never seen.
A week before we landed, oh, those guys are the wrong way, we drifted. But Mao, in his head, he had it all wired.
And they said that you're going off course, you know, and they said cancel the navigation part of it and just get on the compass and start going down. That was one of the times when the crew, as one, with one voice, like, no, let Mao do what he does. That's why we brought him here. Hoku was the first one to spot those thousands of dolphins that came. Mm-hmm. Yeah, he started barking, and I was like, what? And then we looked and we saw it.
We see this light, and we first thought it was a boat. And Mao said, no, it's a land.
But it was good for the people of Mataiva, you know, that we were the first to welcome the canoe. And for us, too, it gave us a chance to breathe. You know, get our wits about us.
And then this little canoe comes along and 20,000 people go down to the beach.
And people are just like, they started wailing like a low hum, and then they got louder and louder and they're chanting and they're waving the canoe in. And you know, I asked the Tahitian guy, what are they saying? He's saying, they're saying, welcome home. They're saying, welcome home. What took you so long to come home? We've been waiting for you for over 200 years. I was like, whoa! Oh my God, talk about chicken skin. I was like crying. I was like, oh my God.
People were reminded, very strongly reminded, without saying anything to them, but just with the canoe being there, that the canoe was a symbol of mutuality among all Polynesians. It was a perfect symbol. So I think the canoe really helped draw Polynesians together again, who had been separated by distance and by history for so long.
I'm glad that, for all of us, for the sake of culture and science, that we made it.
Well, I could look back with satisfaction. We did it.